punched out of line. A promise is a promise, and every time, washing my hands of you. Take it, leave it, you're passing me by. You're holding your hand up and telling me lies. You see what I'm singing, you do what I don't. You're taking a chance to believe in what I'm saying. You're broke back and beaten, you're broke back and beaten, you're broke back and beaten, and it's killing me. You're sick of desire, it's taking me higher. When you do that, I'm down, and then I didn't say. You're sick of desire, it's taking me higher. It's taking me higher, and it's killing me. Whoa. So now I'm feeling blue. Caught in a trap, I didn't know what to do. Your head on my heels and you're pushed out of line. A promise is a promise, happening every time. Washing my hands of you. Washing my hands of you. Take it, leave it, you're passing me by. You're holding your hands up and telling me lies. You see what I'm saying, you do what I don't. You're taking a chance to believe in what I'm singing. You're broke back. You're sick of desire, feelings taking me higher. You did that and down, and then I didn't say. You're sick of desire, it's taking me higher. It's taking me higher, and it's killing me. Whoa. Whoa.
Two, one.
Right,
hello,
on.
And welcome to Articulate.
Wow.
I'm Harry.
And I'm Katie, and that was the amazing to come out.
Wow, that's cool.
Well, thank you so much for being with us today. And we have a massive, massive show for you today. So much going on, and as you can tell, today's a little bit different.
Yeah, I think this kind of Yeah, it works.
I like it.
Yeah, I think it kind of gives away something. Yeah. It feels a bit Christmassy. It's our last show, so yeah, why not? We've got some events that have been happening recently, I think. Firstly, the light show that we were on the other week, that we were live from.
Yeah, that's amazing.
That's still going, isn't it?
What's the date? The
19th, I think it is, yeah.
And it's on every Thursday.
That was great, wasn't it? They had all the stalls and stuff.
Amazing.
Also, they're at the Snow Dome as well.
Yeah,
stuff
going on there.
So the usual skiing and tobogganing and stuff, but it's just more snow and Christmassy, why not?
Yeah, and West Midlands Safari Park are doing celebration-y nights.
Yeah, I think so. I think it's quite a good venue. It's quite a big place, I think, from what I remember. There's bus tours also through all the lights in Birmingham.
Yeah, so you can see all the lights through towns and
stuff. Should be wonderful. Warwick Castle as well.
Warwick Castle are doing something amazing.
They've got loads of good stuff, and their costumes probably maybe not quite as good as ours, but They're all right. Well, yeah, I suppose so. Also, there's some carol singing in Telford. As well as that, also in the Bull Ring, they're doing a collage of people's Christmas trees. So yeah, it's coming up to that time of year where it's getting darker at night, it's getting a bit cold now, and we thought it'd be important to highlight how dangerous it is on the roads this time of year. I know personally, as a young driver, I haven't driven through Christmas or this time of year yet, so it's been really interesting for me to take a look at this. So I wanted you to take a look also.
Yeah, so it's really dangerous sort of
time of year, isn't it? Yeah,
not very nice.
So take a look.
A demonstration of emergency rescue due to an accident that's happened in cold and icy weather conditions. We would like to point out that the person acting as the victim was not harmed at all during this demonstration. As you can see here, the firefighters are first of all taking out their equipment before beginning their work. And here we see the firefighter responding and taking action. Obviously, in a real-life emergency, the firefighters have to be much quicker with the process in order for the victim to survive. Driving in cold and icy weather conditions can cause severe accidents and life-threatening risks. Firefighters are beginning to remove the roof of the car. This will make this easier for them to remove the victim from further harm. The firefighters then have to check for any neck injuries or breathing difficulties. As you can see, they are working quickly and carefully to remove the victim from the vehicle. Once the victim is removed, they are then taken straight to the hospital. It is estimated that young people around the ages of 18 to 25 are more at risk of being involved in an accident at this time of year. Thank you for watching and please drive carefully.
Highlights how this time of year it is really dangerous, and I think it'll be quite a worry to some people.
It's got to be scary, especially being a new driver. Like,
yeah.
Oh, it must be horrible going.
Yeah, I don't even remember practicing in the dark much last year. I must have just avoided it last year because it's such a daunting thing, and now got to face it this year.
But next up, we're looking at Operation Christmas Child, which makes Christmas a lot more special for somebody a lot less fortunate than us. After all, it is a giving time of year, isn't it?
It is indeed. Take a look at Operation Christmas Child.
It's Christmas time.
Operation Christmas Child is a charity, and it's the biggest project of its kind in the world, Christmas gifts for children who have nothing. Out in other countries and worldwide, we go to over 115 countries with shoeboxes, and we send out about 9 million a year. So this country has about a million of those. And this warehouse here and the patch that I cover, which is Worcestershire, Gloucestershire, Oxfordshire and bits of Warwickshire, we have something around 70,000 shoeboxes for Christmas. It's a lot of children with a smile on the face, because the children that we get to have absolutely nothing. And I mean nothing, and a lot of our young people can't actually quantify what nothing is because they've never had nothing. But you go to children who have never ever owned their own pencil or their own piece of paper. They don't know what it is to have a ball to go out and play with, or little cars or skipping rope or something like that. And every box that we get people to make actually puts a smile on a child's face, and you can't put a price on that. So that's actually what we do, and we've been doing it since 1990, when it all started in Wrexham after Ceausescu was overthrown in Romania, and we sent out the very first 3,000 shoeboxes that year. Now we're sending out 9 million. And last year we hit our 100 millionth shoebox. That took 20 years, 22 years. We're hoping to do the next the warehouse here in Evesham, we're classed as a dispatch warehouse. So the boxes come in, I have 9 subsidiary warehouses, so their boxes come into here, but they actually get loaded onto lorries and containers and sent out from Evesham. So when we get boxes in, every box has to be checked. And I say checked, not sorted, because if a thing is in the shoebox that is allowed to go, it has to stay. I'm not allowed, if someone puts in 3 bars of soap, I can't split that and leave 1 in and put 2 into other boxes. We're not allowed to do that. It has to stay. But it's things that aren't allowed that have to be taken out. Some boxes are not up to scratch, if you like. They're half full or half empty, depending on which way you look at it. And they need topping up. It's a way of showing God's love to children who don't know what hope is. So it's a chance to give something to a little one who doesn't know what it is to have a hope.
So that was really cute. I love Operation Christmas Child and everything that it does. I think it's an amazing charity to be a part of.
It is. It's a really good idea. I've never done it before.
Have you not?
Yeah, they used to do them at school, but I was just never invited. Maybe I just had rubbish presents to give.
I've done one most years since I was in primary school.
Okay.
It's just something I've always been really into.
One.
I think it's really cute.
We've got one in here, which we did for...
Is this for a girl aged 5 to 9?
So,
and inside we've got lovely stuff.
Cute little scarf. Got a scarf.
So, I mean, there's loads of do's and don'ts involved in all of the Operation Christmas Child boxes. You're not allowed to put in chocolates and boiled sweets and stuff like that. But any little toys and toothbrushes. Everyone sends a toothbrush. But you really need to send toothpaste of it. You didn't send them toothpaste.
You should send some toothpaste. Toothpaste's a good idea. You're allowed to send that.
Yeah.
Okay.
How it, and soap. Soap's a good one as
soap.
Well.
Yeah.
I mean, I think you should all give it a go. They're an amazing course.
Now we have a wrapping challenge because do you wrap Christmas presents?
I'm not very good. I usually get my nan to do it for me.
I don't think I've ever wrapped a present in my life. So first we've got to wrap headphones, then a balloon.
And then a person.
Okay.
Ooh, right.
When do we know where to go?
Okay, 60 seconds, staff. Now!
Oh my God, where am I sitting?
I just got a dress.
I don't think I've given enough wrapping paper.
Right. Anyway.
Not fair.
That's all we have time for.
My headphones win, though.
All we have time for wrapping. Now we're going to go to another one of my student meals. This week we cooked a turkey sandwich and also some mince pies as well, so check it out, it's very Christmassy.
Hello and welcome to another episode of Student Meals, special Christmas edition. I was thinking, what do you do with your leftovers on Boxing Day? We always have this big dilemma of there's so much food left over. So I'm going to make a turkey stuffing and cranberry sandwich. So I've got all my stuff here. So bread-wise, just anything that's left over. Anything that's left over on Boxing Day, you don't care what you eat. We've got that, and then we're going to make some mince pies as well. So I've got some mince meat, I've got some dark chocolate as well I'm going to put in that, just to get that richness in there. And then just some pastry. It's going to be really easy to make, and it will impress your mum on Christmas Day if you make some mince pies. Right, let's get cracking.
Slice your chosen bread, and then spread on your cranberry sauce. Add your stuffing and then add your meat. You can use chicken, turkey or just whatever you have left over. Now for the mince pies. Flour your work surface to prevent the pastry from sticking. Cut the paste into squares and then put them into the tins. Trim the pastry and use a rolling pin to help if you need. Then roll out some more pastry and cut a shape for the top layer. I use stars. Now you can fill your mince pies. I added dark chocolate, but if you don't want it, just leave it out. Put them in the oven for 20 minutes at gas mark 6.
That was really easy to make. We've got our turkey sandwich, but we've also got our mince pies. What a better way to celebrate Christmas. They're all nice and warm and ready to go. Cheers guys, we'll see you soon. I'm gonna go and eat some of this sandwich, but it's great.
Thank you.
this is amazing costume.
Thank you very much for that. We're going to be hearing from you again in a little minute, but firstly, I noticed that you're all from different places. How did you all form? How did you get together?
Dating website.
Dating website, yeah, okay.
That's how it went down. Yeah. That's how it went down.
Band.com.
Yeah,
that's quite cool.
It was like met from the stars. I shouted out to Matty, come down, Amy, come down. Oh, he's a nice cape, by the way.
Thank you, great. Thank you.
Nice. Yeah, look, but you can never have enough outfits at Christmas.
Very true, very true.
Yeah, exactly.
It's brilliant. So, your guy's massive single, See Your Lovers. I couldn't read. It's fine. Has over 18,000 views on YouTube. So what's next for you all? You're getting so big
There's been a lot of changing in the melt the last few weeks. I mean, Amy's just got on board, so she's giving us a bit of punch on the album which we're doing.
We've been doing what's it called?
Jupatus Barbatus.
A mouthful.
I mean, March 15th.
Yeah.
And what?
It's a mouthful.
And we are actually planning a huge scale Hollywood blockbuster music video with yourselves for Evil Insane.
Wonderful.
It's so much to look forward to, isn't it?
I know it is. Unfortunately, that is all we've got time for. We've got to wrap it up really quickly, but it's been wonderful. We're going to hear from you guys in just a second, but we'd like to say a big thank you to everyone that's been involved in this
show. Thank you for supporting us through this amazing series, but that's the end.
What's been your favourite part?
The pumpkin.
Me with the pumpkin, really?
Yeah.
That was just dangerous.
You almost gave everyone a heart attack. It's brilliant.
But thank you. Thank you very much anyway, and we'll see you all soon.
I'm going to exit the show with the amazing Stubble Melt.